The AMD's FX7500 is a Kaveri accelerated processing unit. It's a low power, rather ultra low voltage, that's what it's called, processor intended for notebooks. And we'll take a look at some of the top level things about this processor and how it performs. So the Kaveri architecture is based upon the Bulldozer design as far as the CPU part of this APU goes. So the APU has two parts, a CPU and a GPU, the processor and the graphics. The processor part is based upon the Bulldozer design, which is essentially it's actually a two core, but there are four integer modules. So basically, the mathematical section is more powerful, and some of the people they count it as quad core, and others if we are counted as dual core. We will adopt the AMD's nomenclature, which names it as quad core, but you should keep in mind that the actual performance will be somewhere in between dual core and a quad core. It's clocked aggressively at 2 GHz with 3.3 GHz turbo clock, which is pretty good given the fact that it's TDP rating has it's only 19 watts, matching the 15 watts of the Intel's Haswell processor. So 4 watts of extra TDP, but we have aggressive clocking, and we'll see that its graphics is much better. Now FX7500, it's manufactured using 28 nanometer manufacturing technology of GlobalFoundries. So Intel does, AMD does lack in terms of manufacturing capability, where Intel, for example, produced its Haswell processor with 22 nanometer, and it's about to go with the Broadwell with 14 nanometer technology. And Intel, it looks like, is going to transition from 28 nanometer to 20 nanometer, so it's still lagging from Intel in terms of manufacturing capability. The processor has 4 MB of L2 cache, which is good for it helps in speeding up the things by storing the recently used processors and programs in its cache memory. Graphics is a Radeon R7 series that has a clock up to 533 MHz, and we will take a look at the GPU performance. But for the CPU performance, it's similar to Intel's Haswell Core i3-4100U ultra low voltage performance. So AMD is catching up with Kaveri in terms of CPU performance, in as much as Intel is trying to catch up AMD in graphics performance. So 7500 is still it's a decent processor for your daily computing needs, including website browsing, word processor, and so on and so forth. But if you are looking for a very high performance notebook, you have many other options, including Intel's Core i7 and i5 processors. The graphics performance should be similar to GeForce GT720M, which is pretty good considering that this graphic is a part of that whole APU in a single processor. And it's no, you don't cannot play most of the games in their high setting or the recent games, but many of these games should be playable in low and medium settings. That's what we have for FX7500, giving a broad overview of this APU from AMD. Pretty good for entry-level computing needs, some of the low-end gaming needs, and pretty much everything you want to do with this processor. You have other options, of course, for higher price. The FX7500, we believe, is pretty priced on low end, and that's good for your budget. You'll have some more updated information on this APU, so keep looking in the description section and leave your comment. Thanks for taking a look.